different IPRs that are important in a pharma field? According to you, we have studied different types of IPRs, right? So out of that, which are the important IPRs in a pharma field? Yes, anyone? And why these are important? Am I audible to all of you?
Yes, sir.
Then answer. We have discussed till now, I think, 5 or 6 IPRs. Out of that, which IPRs are important in pharmaceutical fields? And why they are
patent?
Yeah, okay, patent, that is obviously, it is a very important IPR in pharma field. Apart from the patent, just don't think like a pharmacy that you are producing the new drug. You have to think in all the aspects where these particular IPRs are required in the industry. Obviously, we require industrial design to protect the specific designs. Simple example, if you are producing the tablets, the engraving you are providing on tablet, in simple your logo or anything, it is a 2D structure or the 3D structure that we have engraving on our product. So where our industrial designs play important role. Another one, IPR, apart from the patent, obviously we are going to discuss about the patent in detail because that is the important IPR we required in a pharmaceutical product launch. Another one important IPR which is required in a pharmaceutical product launch, that is a trademark. If you formulate new drug or if you formulate a new invention, so obviously you required to have some brand name for that drug or that formulation, and that brand name has to be protected under the trademark, right? So likewise, along with that, Biodiversity Act also plays important role in a pharmaceutical product formulations, because you have to take the permission from the government to utilize the natural resources for formulating any formulations, right? So these are the different IPRs that are required or that are basically important in a pharmaceutical product launch. So we can say the intellectual property rights are commonly one of the most important economic assets of any corporate entity and for the research organizations. If you see the today's global economy, the knowledge is emerging as one of the most fundamental economical forces. So for that purpose, the strong IP system must be there. We have seen the different advantage or different, we have seen the importance of each and every IPR. Why patents are important, why industrial designs are important, or why trademark is important. So we know the importance of each and every IPR. Suppose simple thing, if patent law is not there in India or anywhere, what will happen? If you have formulated any product, if you have invented any products, anybody can utilize that product. You are investing to develop that product, you are investing money, you are investing the time, and once it comes in the market, anybody can copy that product, right? So all your money, all your time, that will get waste. Same if you have established one trademark, if you set one brand, so with that name anybody can sell anything. Means तुमचा जर ब्रँड खराब करत असेल तर ब्रँडचे तुमचं ब्रँडचं नेम घेऊन कोणीही तो ब्रँड युटिलाइज करू शकतो मार्केटमध्ये. सो बेसिकली स्ट्रॉंग आय पी सिस्टीम मस्ट बी देअर टू अवॉइड ऑल दिस थिंग. अँड ॲज अ फार्मास्युटिकल इंडस्ट्री, ॲज वी आर टॉकिंग, वी नो द रिसेंट कंडिशन. जेवढे डिसीज वाढत चालले, ऑब्व्हियसली त्या प्रत्येक डिसीजला तुम्हाला कोणती ना कोणती तरी एखादी मेडिसिन शोधावी लागणारच आहे.
रिसेंटली कोरोनावर मेडिसिन शोधली जाते. बेसिकली न्यू मॉलिक्युल्स कोणताही अजून इन्व्हेंट केला गेला नाही आहे. आपल्याला प्रोसेस माहित आहे, तर एखादा प्रोडक्ट फ्रॉम मॅन्युफॅक्चरिंग टिल द बेड साईड म्हणजे जोपर्यंत पेशंट पर्यंत पोहोचायला किती टाइम लागतो, जवळपास 12 ते 15 वर्षाचा तो टाइम ड्युरेशन लागतो. प्रत्येक त्याचे स्टेप्स आहेत, मग त्या क्लिनिकल ट्रायल्सचा फेज असतील, तुमच्या पेटंट ऍप्लिकेशनच्या फेजेस असतील. सो इट विल टेक्स लॉंग टाइम अँड अपार्ट फ्रॉम दॅट इट विल इन्व्हेस्ट ऑर इट विल इन्व्हॉल्व द कॉस्ट ऑल्सो. सो डेव्हलपिंग अ न्यू ड्रग अँड सक्सेसफुली ब्रिंगिंग टू द मार्केट विच इज अ व्हेरी रिस्की ॲज वेल ॲज अ लेंथी प्रोसिजर्स अँड इम्पॉर्टंटली विच इज अ एक्सपेन्सिव्ह प्रोसेस. So as I have talking about the pharmaceutical things, I will not go about all other things. We will only concentrate on the pharmaceutical products because we know there are different phases are there in the clinical trials, phase 1, phase 2, phase 3. Then post-marketing surveillance is also there. So it will contains the lengthy process. Even we have seen when we are applying for the patent, it will not be easily getting. There is a step-by-step process. Like primary examinations will be there, scrutinization will be there, then publications will be there, pre-grant opposition, post-grant oppositions, and then you will get the patent if you have the all the criteria which is stated under the patent law. So basically, the cost of one pharmaceutical product is starting from the manufacturing to comes into the market, which is around $750 million. So the discovery of the new drug, which is the only way to address the challenge of the current and the emerging diseases. As we all know, the Indian pharma industry is one of the growth trajectory, being the third largest in the term of volume and the sixth largest in terms of the values. Totally means India, which is the we can say the market of the generic product. So Indian generic accounts for 20% of the total global exports in terms of the values. And if you consider the branded, as we know, it will accounting from the 70 to 80% of the total market. So you can imagine how the development of the pharma sector in India is tremendous. And if you are considering as per the CAGR report, means as per the report, the compound annual growth rate of pharmaceutical industry is projected to the 20% for the next 5 years. So we are thinking like in 2020 India will be the pharma house in worldwide, but because of the some conditions it will not be possible. But as per the report, कंपाउंड ॲन्युअल ग्रोथ रेट जो आहे फार्मास्युटिकल इंडस्ट्रीचा हा 20% ही पर इयरली वाढत जातो. आणि जर आपण आता कन्सिडर केलं तर इन 2025 नाऊ इंडियन फार्मास्युटिकल इंडस्ट्री स्टँड ॲट $20 billion. बट इफ यू आर कन्सिडरिंग ॲज अ ग्रोथ ऑफ 20% CAGR, सो इट विल बी एक्सपेक्टेड टू ग्रो अप टू $100 billion. By 2025. So as we know, the government has taken the steps to reduce the healthcare cost, which will lead to the speedy launch of the generic drugs and shifting the benefits of the domestic firms. So prior to the independence, or not the independence, after the independence, when India want to develop the pharmaceutical industry, what will happen is the multinational corporations, MNCs companies were invited to come to India and to help to develop the industry. So as we know, the patent law apply India madhe khup means patent law apply India madhe khup late established kela gela. Tyamule kay zalo ki means before 1972, before the patent law we are establishing, the MNCs, the multinational companies India madhe aala, basically these particular MNCs themselves were not very neat for manufacturing in India, but basically they have some patent with them. As such, India don't have the patent, So what they decided, they will utilizing their monopoly rights. And that's why in one articles I have read that monopoly rights that is given to the specific company or the inventor, which is a negative rights. Why it is so? Because in effect the patent is financial property, it is limited property rights. We have seen the rights of patentee, right? So basically a patent does not provide the owner the rights to exploit their inventions. So it is no guarantee of the validity as well as the enforceability. So as I have said, the patent, which is the negative right, because it gives the owner the right to prevent the others from making the use of selling the inventions without permissions. So basically, as we are saying, all the inventions are for human being purpose. So this right is obviously pratyek nadalcha don baju astat tashat chacha patent sathi pad ahe. So basically the patent that provides the owners with the legal monopoly enabling them to stop the competitors and profit from the others' inventions, from the others' competitors. So that's why when you are comparing the patent as a more important source of the, or we can say the more important intellectual property rights as in a pharmaceutical product launching. So obviously, like a coin which is having the both the sides. So that we are going to discuss in today's lectures, how these IPRs are important in a product launch. But as I have said, before 1972, means before the patent law enacted in India, so most of the MNC come to the India to establish themselves. So after the 1972, the monopoly power of MNCs were eliminated, and then the industrial globalization will take place in India. After the TRIPS agreements will be there, when India joins the TRIPS agreements, and then what are the rules, means when India signed the WTO, World Trade Organization, then the smoothness will be take place. And in 2005, amendments in a Indian Patent Act. So previously we know the product patents are not there, only the process patents are there. Now the product and the process patents are both are given to the owner. So these developments help in developing the pharmaceutical or the globalization of the pharmaceutical industry in India. So it becomes more and more costly to discover and develop the new drugs and for the inventor to recoup its cost. Just now I have explained more than $750 million. So here they have given average $1 billion will take place starting from the raw materials, or starting from the synthesis process to discover the new molecules. They are till to formulate that product into specific formulation, then to the product launching. So there are various aspects. Means not only that things ki fakta tumhi pharmaceutical product launch madhe fakta tumcha product development hai. Pharmaceutical product launch मध्ये तुमचा product development पासून product तो एकदा formulations मध्ये convert करण्यापर्यंत आणि तिथून मग तो product launch करेपर्यंत, पण market मध्ये already product available आहेत, त्या market त्या product च्या आहे, तुमचा product हा कसा beneficial आहे किंवा कसा तो compete करू शकतो, you have to represent to the customer. मग त्याच्या various methods आहेत, marketing methods किंवा strategies असतात marketingच्या. So त्यासाठी पण तुम्हाला इन्व्हेस्ट करावा लागतो मनी. सो दॅट्स वाय फार्मास्युटिकल लॉन्चिंग ऑफ एनी प्रोडक्ट इज नॉट सो मच इझी, कारण आपल्याला माहिती आहे की आता जेनेरिक ड्रग्स मार्केट मध्ये खूप येत आहेत. सो यूज ऑफ दॅट जेनेरिक ड्रग्स ओव्हर द ब्रँड ड्रग याला कुठेतरी रिस्ट्रिक्शन्स राहतात. So the cost that we have invested in a development of that particular product, that must be recovered once you formulate the product. So according to that, so
so to recover that product, these particular IPRs are the main assets in your market. So if you protected kela asal, then obviously you will get that benefit. If you have the protected trademark, that is one more advantage. If you have the protected industrial designs, that plays also important role in the product launching also. So these are the IPRs, they are interconnected with each other. Not like that just you will get a patent and you will get you will take the benefits of all the things. If you want to launch your product successfully in a market, so you have to take all the IPRs collectively and then you can launch into the market and then you will get the proper benefit. So IP rights that encourage the discovery, recognize the innovations as being essential for the industry development and bring improvement to the public. As already I have discussed, before the patent law and after the patent law, what are the conditions are in India. And still now we can say, as such, we are now on a third rank on the global. So it will be, because we know India, which is the market of the generic product, that is provided 20% global product, generic product worldwide. And if you are considering the branded product, it will be more than 70-80% is produced by the from the India. But basically, the main thing is that most of the MNCs companies are there in India. Have you heard about that Indian companies having their specific R&D department? No. There is a few companies who is at the Indian base, they having their own R&D department. But if you see the multinational companies, they having their R&D plant in India. Because they know the manpower that is required, it will be available here. The cost effective, the taxes that they have to pay in India, which are less as compared to the other countries. The raw materials which is required for the formulating the formulations that are easily available and which is cheaply available in India. But most of the Indian companies are not invested their money in R&D department. Nowadays, the total total income of specific industry, they has to be invested 10% of that on R&D. Then only the India will be the global competitor. So to recognize the innovation that we have lacking in India, and as we know, India, we are not following standard as compared to the other countries that they are following. आपण बघतो की मोस्टली ज्या इंडियन बेस्ड कंपनीज आहेत त्यांचे US ऑडिट फेल गेले, पण कधी आपण बघत नाही की एखाद्या MNC चा ऑडिट फेल गेले US. वी आर फॉलोइंग GMP फॉर बोथ द प्रोडक्शन, म्हणजे जे आपण इंडियन साठी प्रोड्यूस करणार आहात तेच आपण US पीपल साठी मटेरियल असेल किंवा इक्विपमेंट असेल किंवा सेम मॅन पॉवर युटिलाइज करणार, मग का फेल? So that is lacking of that investment in a proper way. We are following GMP. What is GMP? Yes? What is GMP? आहार की सोपला है कि कस का पावसामुळे गारठला है? ओके, बघायचं बोलतो.
गुड मॅन्युफॅक्चरिंग प्रॅक्टिसेस.
या ओके सो हियर मोर देन 90% ऑफ द WHO एसेंशियल ड्रग रिलीज इज ऑफ पेटेंट. So before the creations of the IPR scheme, the knowledge was not widely disseminated and the societies could not benefit from this disclosed information. So as already I have discussed before, the Indian Patent Act, what is the conditions of the pharma industry, and now we can see how the Indian pharma industry is growing after day by day. So the IPR allows science to progress and people to benefit from the new discoveries. Within the same therapeutical classes, a considerable competitions exist in terms of the quality, efficacy and the price. So we have to thanks to IPR, the generic industry can have full access to data related to the inventions and the discovery. So we can carry out the prior research before going for the any inventions. What exactly available in the market and what we have to develop. So as already I have discussed, there is lots of competitions in the market. So how your product is different from already available product in the markets in terms of the quality, in terms of the efficacy, or also the important thing in terms of the price. So to cover all that things, obviously if you take any IPR, like you have to launch the product, you have to consider the design or the whatever the dosage forms are available. So all these informations or this relative data of that particular inventions and the discovery has maintained in a specific means under the specific jurisdictions. So these IPRs playing the very important role. So for the innovation for the better health, as already we have discussed, and we are facing in today's life also, we have still now we have not received any medicine for coronavirus, but still the process is going on. Means like some of the organizations are at clinical on a phase 3 process, some of on a phase 2 process. So it will be the lengthy process as well as the costly process. So to recover the benefits of that cost they have invested towards the specific process, this IPRs plays very much important role. So the TRIPS agreements, as we have already know, so according to the TRIPS agreement, pharmaceutical product patent represent one of the most divisive issues being opposed by the developing countries. Because of the concern that stronger patent protections would hinder the access of drugs and prevent the development of the domestic pharmaceutical industries. So after the TRIPS agreements, so the TRIPS agreement is the result of delicate and careful negotiations humanity needs it in order to continue to progress. So those are the TRIPS agreements, and those who have signed the WTOs. So TRIPS agreement forced the developing countries members of the WTO to grant the patents with the statutory lifetime of 20 years from the patent applications to the pharmaceutical compounds also. So as I said previously, there is only process patents are there. Now product patent as well as the process patents are available. Are available in India also. So what a good IP system includes? So the good IP system includes adequate standards of the protections, system for applying the standards, and limited exceptions, and a brief and effective transition period. मला एखादा आय पी सिस्टीम डेव्हलप करायची, तर प्रिव्हियसली 12 ते 15 वर्ष लागायचं एखादा प्रोडक्ट मार्केटमध्ये लॉन्च होण्यासाठी किंवा एखादा प्रोडक्ट मार्केटमध्ये येण्यासाठी. आता तो टाइम कुठेतरी रिड्यूस झाला, इट विल टेक 6 to 7 years or more than 8 to 10 years to comes in a product in a market. So for development of that good IP system, there must be some standards of protections. Specific standards of protections has to be maintained. That's why the amendments has taken place. In specific, after specific time conditions, we have to amend the specific laws. त्याप्रमाणे तुमचे स्टँडर्ड हे कुठेतरी मेंटेन केले जातात. सो इफ यू आर प्रोव्हायडिंग सम प्रोटेक्शन, कारण आपण जे आपण पेटंट घेतो, पेटंट आपल्याला कधी मिळतो, ज्यावेळी आपण आपली इन्फॉर्मेशन गव्हर्नमेंटला डिस्क्लोज करतो, त्यावेळी आपल्याला जर पेटंट भेटतो किंवा त्यावेळी आपल्याला त्याचे राईट्स भेटतात. सो देअर मस्ट बी सम स्टँडर्ड्स. वी आर सीन द राईट्स ऑफ पेटंटिंग, की कधी कधी तो रिवोक केला जाऊ शकतो किंवा कधी सरेंडर करावा लागतो किंवा ज्या काही अदर्स राईट्स आहेत ते. अँड अ स्पेसिफिक सिस्टीम फॉर अप्लाइंग दॅट स्टँडर्ड्स. इट्स नॉट लाईक जस्ट दॅट वी हॅव टू सेट द स्टँडर्ड्स अँड दॅट्स इट. टू अप्लाय दॅट स्टँडर्ड्स वी हॅव द प्रॉपर सिस्टीम. नाउ इंडियन पेटंट ऑब्व्हियसली इज देअर, दे हॅव द व्हेरियस थ्री ब्रांचेस आर ऑल्सो देअर इन स्पेसिफिक ज्युरिसडिक्शन्स. सो बेसिकली दे हॅव फॉलोइंग वन सिस्टीम. What is the steps after the applications, or what is the steps after the other things also. Whenever I will ask the questions, try to answer by unmuting yourself, because during the presentation I can't see your chat box. So for the good IP systems, these points has to be considered: adequate standards of the protection, system for applying the standards, limited exceptions, and a brief and effective transition periods. Means apan bagto ki ata ekda apply kelyavar 3 ते 4 महिन्याने examinations karav lagto, then other process ahet the publications within 3 to 4 month madhe kele jate, ki within 3 month we have to ask for the pre-grant oppositions. So the time transition periods for one step to the another step, that must be the brief and it must be effective. Means it should be give time to represent all those things also. So this is the content, or we can say the good IP system consists. Now the good data exclusivity system. So basically, as I have mentioned in the first slides here, the last point, within the same therapeutic class, considerable computations exist in terms of the quality, efficacy and the price. Thanks to the IPRs, the generic industry can have full access to data related to the inventions and the discovery. So the good data exclusivity system must be there. So that data, it is a key starting point for creating a core competency in a life science, pharmaceutical and biotechnology. What is already available and what is the need of means what is the needs of the market. So you can collect the data, and that's why for each and every IPR, when you are registering, the first step is that you have to carry out the prior art search. We have seen for the patent also, we have seen for the trademark also, and for the industrial designs also. So the data that they have patented or that they have worldwide or any, so which would be the key starting points for creating the any innovations or to maintain the competency. Current obviously competition se evda hai ki tumcha product apan patent madhe baghitla, patent cha criteria, it should be novel, it should be non obvious, and another one criteria is there, usability. Means it should be it should have some industrial applications, right? So with the help of that data exclusivity system, obviously you will get the information about what exactly takes place in that particular field. So this particular data exclusivity systems, it will aims to encourage the development of all the data, like a phase 1, phase 2, phase 3, इज नेसेसरी टू एस्टॅब्लिश दॅट ड्रग इज बोथ सेफ अँड इफिशियस फॉर द ह्युमन कन्झम्पशन अँड टू फुल्ली कंपन्सेट द ओरिजिनेटर फॉर इट्स इफेक्ट्स. नाउ हियर आय जस्ट वॉन्ट टू शेअर वन थिंग दॅट मेनी इन्व्हेन्शन्स इन मार्केट दॅट आर द इम्प्रूव्हमेंट ऑफ द प्रायर इन्व्हेन्शन्स. There are two terms, primary patents and a secondary patent. Primary patent means what? Suppose तुम्ही एखाद्या याच्यामध्ये काहीतरी inventions carried out करताय. So basically, means just now I have explained that that the many inventions that are the improvement of the prior inventions. So in this case, the owner of the improved inventions may exclude the rights of the owner or right of the original inventions. And as well as the same, the original inventor may exclude the rights of the new improvement or the new inventions. So basically under these circumstances, it is the uncommon for the patent to be licensed or acquired patents can be as powerful as the original patent. म्हणजे आपण इम्प्रूव्हमेंट्स कॅरीड आउट करतो त्यावेळी पण त्याच्या काहीतरी कंडिशन्स. सो बेसिकली दिस पर्टिक्युलर डेटा दॅट गिव्स द एनकरेज डेव्हलपमेंट लाईक ॲज मी ह्याला पण तुम्हाला इनिशियली सांगित होतो की इनोव्हेशन्स म्हणजे काय आहे. आपण ज्यावेळी एखादा रिसर्च प्रोजेक्ट कॅरीड आउट करतो त्यावेळी काय करतो की ह्या प्रोजेक्टवर एवढं वर्क झालं सो वी हॅव सम स्पेसिफिक डेटा याच्यामध्ये कोणतं मटेरियल युटिलाइज केलंय किंवा त्याच्यामधून काय आउटपुट निघालंय. सो ऑब्विसली यू हॅव टू इम्प्रूव दॅट डेटा टू से दॅट दिस इज माय रिसर्च वर्क विच इज हॅव्हिंग द डिफरंट आउटपुट दॅट द ओरिजिनल. सो दिस पर्टिक्युलर डेटा एम्स टू एन्करेज द डेव्हलपमेंट ऑफ ऑल द डेटा विच इज नेसेसरी टू एस्टॅब्लिश दॅट ड्रग विच इज गोइंग टू बी यूज फॉर द ह्युमन कन्झम्पशन विच इज सेफ ॲज वेल ॲज इफेक्टिव्ह. देन it provide the incentives which is outside of traditional forms of the IPR for the companies to invest in research and the clinical development of the drugs combinations and uses. So as already I have discussed regarding the R&D department or the R&D systems in India, we have not much invested on R&D department nowadays. The only thing is that the productivity, you have to produce the product, whether it is a qualitative or whether it is a quantitative, which is depends upon the company's policies. I will not go in detail about that. Quality product jar tumhala produce karaycha asel kiwa jar ekada pharmaceutical product chi quality tumhala maintain karaycha asel tumhala tevda product ha launch tevda money tumhala yacha madhe invest kela pahije. I will just share one example. Javya ami industrial visit la gelo hoto, IDPL company, which is government based company, इंडस्ट्रियल विजिट दिली होती इन 2016 or 2017. त्यावेळी ती कंपनीची कंडिशन अशी होती की ज्या ठिकाणी मॅन्युफॅक्चरिंग आहे त्याच साईडला लगेच तिथे ड्रेनेज होतं त्याचं आणि ते प्रॉपरली कव्हर पण केलं गेलं नव्हतं. तिथे वर्कर्स वर्किंग करतात, तिथे ना त्यांनी ग्लोव्ह युटिलाइज केले ना आपण जसं हेडकॅप किंवा मास्क युटिलाइज करतो, ओपन हँडेडली टॅबलेट्स हँडल करतात किंवा ऑल दोज थिंग चालू आहेत. So at the end, I have asked one question to that manager whether your product is, means productivity is qualitative or just quantitative. फक्त तुम्हाला क्वांटिटी प्रोड्यूस करायचे की क्वालिटी प्रोडक्ट प्रोड्यूस करायचे. कारण ऑब्विसली जर आपण त्या कंपनीमध्ये बघितलं, तुम्ही जर त्या कंपनीमधली कंडिशन बघितली असती तर तुम्ही त्या कंपनीचा कधीही प्रोडक्ट बाय केला नसता. So that's why whatever the incentives we are getting from this IPR, we have to properly utilize them. Not just utilizing them for our benefits. You can develop your product also. You can invest in product, means representing your product in a market. You can you can invest in improvement of their efficacy. You can increase the test or the efficacy also. So that incentives which is coming from the IPRs, that must be invested in proper ways, which will not happen in Indian pharmaceutical sectors. Suppose the developments and testing of new active ingredients, particularly when patents are not available. Just now I have explained these things. We have to invest in a proper way. So the development and the testing of the new active ingredients when the patent is not available, so you have to take the proper precautions during that stage also. प्रोडक्टची एक स्टेज असते, इनिशियल स्टेज, देन कंटिन्युटी स्टेज अँड देन डिक्लाइन स्टेज. म्हणजे मार्केटमध्ये लॉन्च केल्याची जी स्टेज आहे, त्यानंतर काही वेळ प्रोडक्ट हा सस्टेनेबली त्या रेंजने सोल्ड केला जातो किंवा विकला जातो, एक प्रोडक्ट लेवल मेंटेन केलं जाते, पण कदाचित त्याला कॉम्पिटेटर येतो एखाद्या प्रोडक्टचा आणि त्याची स्टेज ही डिक्लेअर होतो, कुठेतरी तो जो काही सेल आहे तो कुठेतरी कमी व्हायला लागतो. सो ज्यावेळी आपण न्यू ऍक्टिव्ह इन्ग्रेडियंट लॉन्च करत असतो, आता सिम्पल एक्झाम्पल, एखादी टूथपेस्ट घेतली, पहिली मार्केटमध्ये फक्त कोलगेट होती, आता इतक्या प्रकारच्या टूथपेस्ट मार्केटमध्ये अवेलेबल असते की कोलगेट कुठेतरी आता बघायला पण काय काय वेळा भेटत नाही, प्रत्येकाच्या घरी वेगवेगळ्या टूथपेस्ट. सो प्रत्येक प्रोडक्टचा एक काहीतरी टाइम ड्युरेशन असतो किंवा एक ग्राफ असतो बेसिकली, की इनिशियल पिरियड, मॅच्युरिटी पिरियड अँड लास्ट म्हणजे डिक्लाइन स्टेजला ज्यावेळी तो येतो. सो ज्यावेळी तो डिक्लाइन स्टेजला येतो एखादा प्रोडक्ट, सो यू हॅव टू थिंक इन अनदर वे दॅट की हा तो डिक्लाइन झालेला स्टेजला आहे, तिथून पुन्हा तो कसा वरती येईल. सो डेव्हलपमेंट मस्ट बी देअर, सो वी हॅव टू युटिलाइज दॅट incentives which is coming out from the IPRs, that you have to invest in the proper ways. So the development costs are also there. The companies are challenged to reduce the cost and increase the productivity and efficiency. But apart from that, IPR companies also have to invest in a product launch. Means they have to arrange some physician education programs. They have to arrange or they have to carry out some clinical research, they have to carry out some public awareness efforts, they have to face the corporate philanthropy. So basically what exactly as I want to told you is that IPRs are not restricted. म्हणून मग अशी म्हटलं की फक्त पेटंटच फार्मास्युटिकल प्रोडक्ट लॉन्च मध्ये इम्पॉर्टंट नाही आहे, किंवा त्या प्रोडक्टची कॉस्ट ही फक्त ती डेव्हलपमेंट कॉस्ट नाही आहे, तो प्रोडक्ट सिंथेसिस झाल्यापासून तो प्रोडक्ट मार्केटमध्ये लॉन्च होईपर्यंत ज्या काही सगळ्या स्टेप्स आहेत, प्रमोशन्स करावं लागतं प्रत्येक गोष्टीचं. अनलेस अँड अंटिल पीपल विल नॉट अट्रॅक्ट टू युअर प्रोडक्ट. आता ऑब्व्हियसली फार्मास्युटिकल सेक्टर आहे म्हटल्यावर आता एमआरस असतात की जे तुमचा प्रोडक्ट रिप्रेझेंट करतात, एखादा नवीन प्रोडक्ट लॉन्च केल्यावर त्यांना फिजिशियन्सना जाऊन कन्सल्ट करावं लागतं की हा प्रोडक्ट असा बेनिफिशियल असेल. किंवा जे आपण क्लिनिकल ट्रायल्स बघतो, ट्रायल 1, ट्रायल 2, ट्रायल 3 आणि ट्रायल 4 फेजेस आर देयर, सो द प्रत्येक फेजमध्ये तेवढा मनी त्याच्यामध्ये कुठेतरी इन्व्हेस्ट करावा लागतो. देन यू हॅव टू अवेअर द पब्लिक ऑल्सो अँड ऑब्व्हियसली वी नो द कॉर्पोरेट लॉबीज. How we have to face. Even simple thing, if you want to start distributorships or if you want to start any retail shop is also, there is a specific lobbies that we have to face also. So the development cost. Apart from that, this tablet banwala karna ek 20 paise kiwa 30 paise kharcha ala asel, par to 30 tablet market madhe 5 rupaye kiwa 10 rupaye vikle jate. तो खर्च फक्त डेव्हलप फक्त तो प्रोडक्शनचा खर्च नसतो. आपण काय म्हणतो की हा ॲट अ टाइम थोडेच ते सिंगल टॅबलेट बनवणाऱ्या टायमाला त्याच्या लाखो टॅबलेट्स असतात, सेम मशीन युटिलाइज करतात, सेम मॅनपॉवर असते, मग एवढी कॉस्ट का वाढते. सो ऑल दिस कॉस्ट इज इन्क्लुडेड इन दॅट पर्टिक्युलर प्रोडक्ट. ती फक्त प्रोडक्शन कॉस्ट नसते, त्या प्रोडक्शनसाठी लागणाऱ्या सगळे पॅरामीटर्स, पॅकेजिंग कॉस्ट त्याच्यामध्ये इन्क्लूड असते, तुमच्या इव्हॅल्युएशन क्वालिटी कंट्रोल कॉस्ट त्याच्यामध्ये इन्व्हॉल्व्ह असते, रॉ मटेरियल कॉस्ट इन्व्हॉल्व्ह असते, जे तुम्ही सॉरी युटिलिटीज ज्या युटिलाइज केल्या आहेत, म्हणजे तुम्ही लाईट सप्लाय असेल, सॉरी वॉटर सप्लाय असेल, सो त्याची सगळ्यांची कॉस्ट ही त्याच्यामध्ये इन्क्लूड केलेली असते. So what are the different potential partnership with the pharmaceutical industry? So obviously public sectors as well as private sectors also. So it is important to better serve the local markets and create the long term goals if you are to establish your product in a market. So before going for the global market, इट इज बेटर टू सर्व द लोकल मार्केट फर्स्ट, बिकॉज द मेन थिंग टू सर्व द लोकल मार्केट एंड द ग्लोबल मार्केट, द ऑब्लिगेशंस एज वेल एज द रूल्स एंड रेगुलेशंस आर डिफरेंट इन डिफरेंट कंट्रीज, राइट? So for that purpose, obviously we have seen if you have filed the PCT applications, what will be happens and how much time it will takes. But the same thing, the other point of, if you see the other point of view, so for the long term goal, if you are thinking that I have to launch or I have to get the benefit from that particular product for 5 years or the 10 years, so first you have to concentrate on a local market and you have to create the long term goals. Then you have to contribute with the transfer of technology and its competencies, contribute to the economical as well as the social development, and bring additional resources to populations most in need. So these points you have to consider while means if you think that you have to develop your product for your, or you have to get a benefit from the product at a specific time durations. So what are the technologies there that you have to utilize properly, and you have to, I mean, like a means apart from the innovation, obviously the public side utilize karto apart, but tachi ji information se kahi transfer ahe ki wa jo competence ahe market madla to properly kuthe tari balance zala pahije. किंवा जे कॉम्पिटिशन्स आहे मार्केटमध्ये त्याला कुठे तुम्ही एक स्ट्रॉंगली तिथे पण त्याच्यामध्ये स्टेबल राहायला पाहिजे. अनदर थिंग्स दॅट यू हॅव टू कन्सिडर प्रायोर टू इन्व्हेस्टिंग, दॅट इज कंट्री पॉलिटिकली अँड इकॉनॉमिकली स्टेबल्स, बॅरियर्स टू द एंट्री लाईक अ करन्सी रिस्ट्रिक्शन्स, स्लो रेग्युलेटरी अप्रुव्हल्स, कारण आपण बघितलंय की काही काही स्टेटमध्ये अजूनही तेवढे लॉज एम्पोज केले नाही आहेत. सिंपल एक्झाम्पल आपण जर घेतलं गल्फ कंट्री, सिरिया वगैरे जर कन्सिडर केलं, त्या ठिकाणी जर तुम्ही इन्व्हेस्ट करायला गेलात तर ऑब्व्हियसली तेवढा लॉस सुद्धा होणार आहे, कारण तिथली कंडिशन तुम्हाला माहिती आहे. सो देर आर डिफरंट फॅक्टर्स आर देअर दॅट हॅज टू बी कन्सिडर प्रायर टू द इन्व्हेस्टिंग. सो कंट्रीज पॉलिटिकली अँड इकॉनॉमिकली स्टॅबिलिटी, बॅरियर्स टू द एंट्री, समटाइम्स द रेग्युलेशन प्रोसेस इज व्हेरी स्लो फॉर द अप्रुव्हल पर्पज. The size of the local pharmaceutical markets and its growth potential has to be considered. Then importantly, intellectual property protections and enforcement measurement. Patents cha US patent nusar guidelines vegle ahet, European patent nusar guidelines vegle ahet, Indian patents cha under guidelines vegle ahet. So that we have to consider. Then trademarks as well as the copyrights laws. डेटा फॉर द रजिस्ट्रेशन प्रोटेक्टेड फॉर द डिस्क्लोजर. आपण बघितलं की ज्यावेळी आपण पेटंट फाईल करतो देर आर टू फेजेस, नॅशनल फेज सॉरी नॅशनल फेज अँड द इंटरनॅशनल फेज वन्स यू फाईल द पीसीटी ऍप्लिकेशन. सो युअर प्रॉपर्टी प्रोटेक्शन आणि तो तुम्ही त्या पर्टिक्युलर एरियामध्ये कसा इम्पोज करणार त्याचं सगळं नॉलेज तुम्हाला कन्सिडर करायला पाहिजे. ते फॅक्टर्स तुम्हाला कन्सिडर करायला लागतील अलॉंग विथ दॅट WTO members or in process of joining, kontya countries WTO members ahe, and WTO cha members asil to obviously they have to follow the all the agreements they have signed, like a TRIPS agreements are there or NAGO agreements are there or any other agreements that we have that they have following the following by that specific countries. Then CGMP availability, current good manufacturing practices, whether it is available. So I think I have told you in third year also, most of the Indian pharmaceutical companies, they are following the GMP. It is not good manufacturing practices, it is a good manipulation practices that we have also followed in the labs. So the availability of the good manufacturing practice, now good manufacturing practices, it is not a simple concept. The good manufacturing practices, which is the responsibility of every person. Along with that, some multinational companies treated same as local companies, potential to the export from the countries. So the TRIPS agreements will help here, trade related aspects of intellectual property rights, transparent regulatory pricing and the tender processes. As we know, for the India, DPCO plays important role, drug price control order, where we can set the price after the expiration of the patent.
कारण विदिन दॅट स्पेसिफिक स्टॅट्युटेड पिरियड वी आर रिकवरिंग व्हॉट एवर द कॉस्ट वी आर इन्व्हेस्टिंग अँड इम्पॉर्टंटली टॅक्स अँड अदर इन्सेंटिव्ह टू इन्व्हेस्ट. आता आपल्याला म्हणतंय की मेक इन इंडियाच्या अंडर इंडिया बरेच टॅक्स एक्सेप्शन देते जे कोणी इन्व्हेस्ट करणार असतील, किंवा काही काही कंपन्यांना इन्सेंटिव्ह प्रोव्हाइड करते की तुम्ही जर इंडियामध्ये येऊन एखादी कंपनी एस्टॅब्लिश करत असाल तर इंडियन गव्हर्नमेंटकडून तुम्हाला 30% सबसिडी किंवा त्या पर्सेंटने तुम्हाला दिली. सो ह्या सगळ्या गोष्टी तुम्हाला एखाद्या फार्मास्युटिकल कंपनी इन्व्हेस्ट करायची किंवा एखादा प्रोडक्ट तुम्हाला त्या स्पेसिफिक रिजनमध्ये लॉन्च करत असेल तर तुम्हाला म्हणजे एखाद्या कंट्रीमध्ये लॉन्च करत असेल तुम्हाला त्या गोष्टी कन्सिडर कराव्या लागतात. नाऊ दीज आर द अदर फोर. सो दिस इज ऑल रिगार्डिंग द पेटंट जस्ट नाउ आय एम डिस्कसिंग बिकॉज द पेटंट एज वी नो दॅट प्रोव्हाइड द लीगल बेसिस फॉर द कमर्शियल मोनोपोली अँड प्रोव्हाइड द एक्सक्लुसिव्ह मोनोपोली राईट्स इन रिलेशन टू द इनोव्हेटिव्ह प्रोडक्ट ऑर द प्रोसेस. And that particular strong patent or the strong intellectual property system can incite the pointing into the knowledge development and to promote the proper innovation. So apart from the patent, these also play an important role. Industrial design is there. Trademark is also there. So industrial designs, already we have discussed what are the advantages are there. So industrial designs, when you have formulating any designs that will be representing your product. So this law is also very much important. Then trademark, the brand that you are selling, that is also very much important. And the NBA plays important role in whenever you are utilizing the any natural resources. So Biodiversity Act, that will help also help. So these are the different IPRs are there that can be helpful or that is very much important in a pharmaceutical product launching. So I just want to conclude these sessions with that. So when you have deciding to launch the any product or when you are deciding to establish any company, so there are various factors that you have to consider. And importantly, the main or the most important IPR which will help the product launch is your patent, because without patent you cannot go for the further steps. So if you launching any product, so these all IPRs, they have collectively worked together, means patent, trademark and your industrial designs. कारण पेटंट फक्त तुम्हाला काय करणार आहे, फक्त प्रोटेक्शन देणार आहे, तुम्हाला प्रोडक्ट लॉन्चिंग मध्ये काही हेल्प करणार नाही. पण ज्यावेळी तुम्ही एखादा ब्रँड व्हॅल्यू सेट करता किंवा ब्रँड तुम्ही सेट करणार, त्यावेळी तुमचा प्रोडक्ट हा मार्केटमध्ये पॉसिबली किंवा एक सक्सेसफुली लॉन्च होईल. आपण व्हेरियस फॅक्टर्स पण बघितले की कोणकोणते फॅक्टर्स कन्सिडर करायला पाहिजेत डेव्हलपमेंट मध्ये किंवा एखादा प्रोडक्ट लॉन्चिंग मध्ये. सो दॅट ऑल द थिंग्स दॅट यू हॅव टू कन्सिडर व्हाईल एनी फार्मास्युटिकल प्रोडक्ट लॉन्च. सो वी हॅव ऑल्सो डिस्कस रिसेंट कंडिशन्स ऑफ द फार्मा सेक्टर्स, मीन्स बिफोर द इंटलेक्चुअल प्रॉपर्टीज आर देअर इन इंडिया, मीन्स बिफोर द 1972, व्हॉट आर द कंडिशन्स अँड नाऊ हाऊ द इंडिया इज and third globally at the pharmaceutical sectors. And hope so, if as per the survey which is carried out, that if the compound annual growth rate which will be exceeds or the increase by 20% in upcoming 5 years, so obviously and definitely the India will be the one of the powerhouse for the pharma company, the pharma field. So we can export the product to others in other countries also. But the same thing, जसे जशा कॉइनला दोन बाजू आहेत, तर दोन्ही बाजू तुम्हाला कन्सिडर करायला लागतात ज्यावेळी आपण प्रोडक्ट लॉन्च करतो. कारण प्रोडक्ट लॉन्च विच इज नॉट अ इझी थिंग, मार्केटची अवेलेबिलिटी आणि मार्केटची रिक्वायरमेंट काय आहे, मार्केटमध्ये अवेलेबल्स काय आहे आणि तुम्ही त्याचं मार्केटची रिक्वायरमेंट नुसार तुमचा प्रोडक्ट कसा त्याच्यासमोर प्रेझेंट करताय, हे मोस्टली इम्पॉर्टंट आहे. सो दिस इज ऑल रिगार्डिंग द रोल ऑफ आय पी आर इन अ
फार्मास्युटिकल इंडस्ट्री वी कैन से वी नॉट से दैट इज ओनली प्रोडक्ट लॉन्चिंग सो इम्पॉर्टेंटली यू हैव टू कॉन्सेंट्रेट ऑन अ पेटेंट एंड ट्रेडमार्क एंड देन इंडस्ट्रियल डिजाइन इफ द क्वेश्चंस दे विल आस्क आई थिंक यू हैव आस्क्ड द क्वेश्चंस ऑन द सेम थिंग वन मिनट Okay, they explain the rules of IPR in a product launch. They have asked the questions for 3 months. So you can write down the importance of all those IPR which is responsible for the product launching in a pharmaceutical sector. Okay, so we'll stop here. Now only 2 points are remaining. That is the IPR infringements and last one that is the patent cooperation treaty. So that will be covered in upcoming lectures. Okay, thank you.